Learn about centrally managed Azure Hybrid Benefit that's new this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Chris from Business Planning. And Chris, thanks so much for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Thanks, Anna. Sure. I work in business planning, and one of the things I focus on is trying to make Azure the best experience for Windows Server and SQL Server.
Awesome. Cool. It seems like a great person to have on Data Exposed talking about SQL Server and things like Azure Hybrid Benefit. Now, before we get into what's new, can you tell us a little bit about what is Azure Hybrid Benefit?
Sure. So Azure Hybrid Benefit is a licensing benefit that you get when you buy Windows Server and SQL Server licenses with software assurance or within a subscription. And it lets you apply those licenses to Azure and then reduce your costs.
Awesome. Sounds pretty good. Now, how does it work and how do I go about actually getting Azure Hybrid Benefit?
Yeah, so it kind of works like this. So you apply licenses to resources like VMs or SQL databases. And when you do that, it reduces the hourly rate. It basically takes the software part out, and that will reduce the cost. And even if you add the cost of the licenses back in, it's still lower price than the full hourly rates. And so the way you apply it is actually whenever a DevOps person creates a VM or a SQL DB, they'll check a checkbox in the UX, or more likely, they'll use command line interface or API to kind of script it out, and they'll select the benefit on the resource.
Okay, this sounds pretty good, pretty straightforward. It looks like this is done on a per resource basis. So are there any challenges associated with this?
Yeah, so you know, the way things work today, these are DevOps roles that do this. It's done at the level of each resource, and customers have told us that, you know, it's cumbersome to manage that by resource. And then the other problem that they've told us is, you know, those resources may not have awareness of license availability, and so there's concerns about compliance.
Got it. Yeah, that definitely seems like a challenge, especially when you talk about having, like, I don't know, hundreds of SQL servers and trying to manage those licensing, just managing the AHAB and then making sure you're in compliance. So what are we doing to kind of make this a better experience?
Yeah, so we heard the feedback, and we've created a new way to manage Azure Hybrid Benefit that addresses those problems. And essentially, what it is, it allows a different sort of billing admin type person to assign licenses in larger blocks at the overall account level or at a subscription level. And you can assign even just one license assignment to your account level, and that could cover all your licenses. So it's definitely more scalable.
Awesome. Very cool. So how do I like go through it? How does it work? And do you have any tips for folks just getting started?
Sure. It's probably easiest to kind of look at the experience itself in the portal. So I'll do that. The awesome. First thing I'll share is kind of how you get to it. So after you, after an admin logs in, they will click on cost management. And then they'll see this and they'll click on billing scopes, and then they'll select the scope. And then they will select reservations plus hybrid benefit on the left nav bar and click add Azure Hybrid Benefit preview. So you can see this is the same area as reservations under cost management. And when they do that, they'll get to the landing page here for centrally managed Azure Hybrid Benefit. And what's on this screen, it kind of covers the Azure Hybrid Benefit itself, like we kind of did a couple minutes ago. And it introduces this feature, and then it also includes, you can see in the blue here, a prerequisite that's kind of necessary, and that is making sure you register all of your self-installed SQL Server virtual machines. That lets you, or the customer, and the system see all those, and that way you make sure to assign enough licenses. So once that's all done, then you begin to assign licenses. And this is kind of the main screen where all the magic happens. So there's really just two steps. There's choosing a scope, and that's either the whole account or including all the subscriptions in that account, or a specific single subscription. So that's the first step. And then assign licenses. And you can see that you can assign standard edition licenses and enterprise edition licenses. These are kind of all fungible together. And so we have a concept of normalized licenses. And the way that works is one standard license equals one normalized core license, and one enterprise license equals four normalized licenses. So you kind of do that math and you get a total set of core licenses, normalized core licenses. And the experience, actually, you can see in the blue here, it actually does some great work and gives you a currently detected usage amount, both for Azure Hybrid Benefit, that, you know, how many checkboxes are checked that we just looked at a few minutes ago, and then also how many overall resources and cores for compatible resources are running. And so it kind of gives you that information. And then you can use that as well as work behind the scenes to make a decision about how many licenses to assign. In this case, the customer has decided to assign 200 standard licenses and 100 enterprise licenses for a total of 600 normalized. And that's quite a bit more than the detected usage that you see in the blue. And so what that tells us is this customer probably is expecting to increase their usage coming up. Maybe they have a bunch of migrations, or they have a bunch of new projects and they're going to be creating new resources from those. And then after you've done that, you have the opportunity to kind of create customized names. And then kind of the final step before applying these is there's a little attestation that basically just says, I have permission to do this, I can represent my company, and we have the licenses. So you click on that, and the license assignment is created. And once those license assignments are out there, you can go back to that reservations plus hybrid benefit page, and you'll see this table. And within that table, you'll see a row for every one of those license assignments, like the one that was just created in the demo. And you'll see a utilization number for the previous day and the previous 7 days. And this tells you how many of those licenses on an ongoing basis are being used. And the way to think about utilization is, this is the detail screen, by the way. If you click on one of those rows, then you can get to this screen. If your utilization is less than 100%, that means you have more than enough licenses assigned to cover all of the resources. And so if that number approaches 100% or actually gets to 100%, then the admin will want to consider talking to the procurement department and acquiring some more licenses and assigning them. And then that way all the resources can be covered and you can maximize the cost savings. And that's really it. As far as the demo, you can see a link there on the right-hand side as well if you are looking for more information.
Thanks, Chris. This is super useful to see, and it's really interesting how it's going to make it so much easier for customers to manage across their Azure SQL estate. One follow-up question I had, you showed us about SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machine, but I want to understand, can I use this centrally managed Azure Hybrid Benefit for Azure SQL PaaS services, like Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL Managed Instance?
Yeah, you can use it for VMs. You can use it for PaaS, SQL DB, SQL MI. It goes across all those different Azure SQL resources.
Awesome. Cool. That's great. So I really have one place to manage all of my licenses across all of my Azure SQL resources. So thanks so much, Chris. This has been really useful. To our viewers, we're going to put some links in the description so you can go learn more and figure out how to get this enabled for your subscription and your organization. We hope this video was useful. If you like this video, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know that you're using Azure Hybrid Benefit. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.